back to my YouTube channel. For everyone who's new to the channel, hi guys, my name is Trishna and I make videos on beauty, lifestyle, travel. Basically, I try and incorporate everything that's possible on my channel. So today's video is all about review. Recently, like probably 2-3 days ago, I went to the launch of Colourbar Sinful Matte. Basically, it was kind of success party, if I'm not wrong. So this is what they gave me and I'm going to review these lipsticks. Now these are called Sinful Matte Lip Color. There are 8 shades in this, but I'm going to only review 6 because I'm giving away 2 lipsticks. But that will be happening on Instagram, so just in case if you're yet not following me on any of the social medias, that's the link, you can go and follow. And yeah, without further ado, let's get on the video and see these all beautiful kinky shades. Now you might be thinking why I called these kinky, like the shades as kinky, because that's what the name of the shades are. So there are different shades. They have really like OTT, basically over the top names for these shades. Now there are some 24 shades in these. I have removed all of the shades. I really love the packaging that they gave us. So there were the name as Obscene and Provoke, Nasty, Sexy, Triple X, Kinky, Envious, Wicked and Virgin, and all sort of lustful names. So the first shade that I'm trying is called Tainted. Now first of all, let's talk about the packaging. It's a magnetic packaging. I love magnetic packaging. So this is how it looks like. It's called Tainted and it's a nice nudish plumish color. So I don't know if the camera is picking up the color or not, but if you can see right here, it's a nice plumish pinkish shade. They are totally matte. They are super soft on lips, not like your usual matte lipsticks. I really love the way it's gliding on the, you know, on the lips. I really love this shade. One of the major reasons being it's nice plumish shade that's there, and it's matte, but I'm not sure how matte it is. I need to wait for a bit probably to, you know, understand if it's like really matte or does it transfer. So we'll wait for like at least 2-3 minutes. So I really like this shade. This is called Tainted in 4. It takes a while to probably, you know, get matte. It doesn't mattify quickly, so that's one drawback for me. But otherwise it's a beautiful shade. It takes a while for me. I like my lipstick to get, probably matte lipsticks, to dry up quickly. So, you know, because this is not what I like, if you can see. Because I tried doing this. So it takes a while. Now it's completely dry, completely matte. So it looks beautiful. It's a nice plumish shade that can be carried in the day and the night. So this one gets a thumbs up from me, and let's move on to the second shade. So the next shade that I'm gonna try is called Kinky, which I spoke in the first, like, you know, starting of the video. And it's a very beautiful red shade, like one of my favorite kind of reds. I love reds, you guys are aware about it, and this is the kind of shade I really like. The way it's, you know, first of all, I really like the texture. If you open the bullet, it looks pretty. It really looks like it's matte and not shiny, and it glides like butter. Oh my god, that looks fab. This red is you know, with pink undertone. I kind of like with bluer undertones, which gives you a darker finish. But this shade looks fabulous on screen right now if I'm watching it. This is a beautiful shade, beautiful bright shade, meant for all the skin tones. If you are a bit on the darker side, this is perfect for you. If you are on probably fairer side, you will look stunning in this. Someone with my skin tone will rock this color. This is basically for, meant for Indian skin tones. Like, I am crushing over this. I guess I have found my love for red. I wanted this kind of red for really long time. I guess the one which matches closest to this one has to be Ruby Woo. I don't own a Ruby Woo, but I have seen how Ruby Woo looks. It is more on the orangey and pinky tone, What all reds I own are a bit on the bluer tone, which has like a little darker shade. This looks perfect. This looks beautiful. I found my red. So this was Kinky and like totally crushing over this one. Let's move on to the next one. So the next shade is this one. This is called Sultry. It's a very dark plum pink shade. And I am a fan, like I can say I'm a huge fan of plums and reds. This somehow gives me the hint of the first shade that I tried. Probably this is a little more darker than the first one. This one right here on screen, it looks like if it is having a kind of red undertone. But it's actually a very plummy shade, perfect for probably winters. The first shade was Tainted and it gives me the vibe of Tainted somehow. But it looks nice on screen right now. If I look at the screen right now, right here, it really looks nice. It gives me this nice red tone right now. Yeah. So yeah, this is again a very pretty color. Let's move on to the next shade. This is for everyone out there who loves pink, who survives on pink, who can swear by pink. This is the next shade that's called Lustful. It's a very nice royal pink shade. I'm not a huge fan of pinks. I guess I love pinks only in neon shades. The one thing I really love about this lipstick is it doesn't feel cracked. Like, you know, once you apply, usually I've applied a lot of matte lipsticks and certain lipsticks feel that, you know, it's gonna crack any minute. This doesn't feel that way. It's a very nice Barbie dollish kind of color. And it reminds me of like, you know, neon shades that I've owned in the past. But this is a very different color. Its texture is very nice. As I said earlier that, you know, the best part about this lipstick is once you apply, you do not feel that, you know, you're applying a matte lipstick. It doesn't feel cracky. It's nice. The color payoff is beautiful. This is perfect for, again, an Indian skin tone. If you like pinky shades, neon-y shades, this is the color. I guess after red, this is my second favorite. Yeah. I guess it looks good. You can let me know in the comments below which is your favorite. So let's move on to the next shade. So the next shade is for every nude shade lover out there. I am not a fan of nude because somehow it makes my skin or my face, you know, it looks like I'm washed out and ill. So, but I am not saying that I do not apply nudes. I apply nudes only which has brown undertone. So I guess this shade is definitely a brown undertone. So this is called Sing. So let's do the Sing. I'm just gonna replace all my nudes with this one for sure. Can I just like keep staring at the screen instead of here? Do you like really see that? Like it has given me this like sudden, like, you know, like as if my lips have gone like really big. I don't know. I mean, wow. Wow is the word for this color. I really love the brown undertone. I am totally crushing over this. I guess this is my newfound favorite in the nudes. I guess I'll be replacing all my nudes with this one. Highly, highly, highly recommended if you love nudes. It's called Sin. And yeah, I mean, oh my god. Colourpal, you're doing a fab job. I really love this color. Moving on to the last and final shade. Let's guess which is that one. So last but definitely not the least is this shade. This shade is called Provo. And oh my god. Like this is really, really, really dark purple. Really dark purple if you can see. I don't know why somehow they have created so many purple shades. Probably they could have created more of reds because I have only 8 shades. Out of which I'm trying 6. Why I am somehow not impressed with the purple family. Again, all the 3 shades that I applied from the purple family, which is the Sultry, the Tainted, and the last one, which is Provo, somehow all look similar, probably one shade lighter, one shade darker. Yeah, I guess I'm not impressed with the purple family somehow. So let's talk about the pros and cons of Colourpal Sinful Matte. Talking about the pros, there are 24 shades, they are beautiful, They are like, you know, really nice and the color payoff is amazing. Apart from that, if I talk about cons, let's start with the pricing. It's heartbreaking to talk about the price. It's 1200 rupees for a Bullet and it's a bit pricey. I mean, keeping every good thing aside, if I am a college going student probably, it is a bit pricier for me. I'd not invest 1200 rupees for this. Apart from that, I'm not happy with the Purple family. All these three shades that I tried are almost the same. So that is one thing. And last but definitely not the least, it takes a lot of time to dry. Like if you're a matte lipstick, it has to dry instantly, but somehow it takes a lot of time. It does take a lot of time. So that's three cons for me. But pros, yes, it glides nicely. It's a nice product. Color payoff is really beautiful, like the shades which were in pinks and red family. But purples don't work for me, all look the same. So yeah, I guess that's all about it. You can make a call if you want to buy this or not. What do you think about this video? Please do let me know in the comments below. Which is your favorite shade? Do comment that as well. If you have any dupes, you can let me know for that as well. And if you like this video, do not forget to give a big fat thumbs up. And do not forget to subscribe, because subscription is absolutely free. And till the time I come back, please do take care of yourself and miss me.